The spirit of the Antichrist, Dajjal, is everywhere. The system is already here. The secret societies of this earth try everything to control mankind, to push forward the Antichrist agenda of the New World Order. Through music and entertainment and the world of politics, many try their hardest not to believe this and simply say these things are conspiracy theories. But no one should reject something without looking deep into it. Never reject anything simply because you don't like it. I want to give you a little overview of the things these secret societies do about the elite of this world, those that control the earth. You may not like it, you may not believe it, but it will not change the fact that this is the truth. Narendra Modi rises to power in India, becomes almost a messianic figure, a king figure, ushering in the era of Hindutva and supremacy over 1.2 billion people. He's established a new company to be used by the elite, a company of blind followers who will do exactly what he says without a question and without protest. Trump blows the trumpet in America that divides people from all walks of life, black, white, rich, poor, Republican and Democrat, everyone's against one another. But the evangelicals back Trump and are united in their quest to bring Jesus back to earth. Again, blind followers who will do everything without question. Netanyahu's focused on establishing ties with politicians from around the world, whether it's Jair Bolsonaro from Brazil or bobblehead Boris Johnson from Great Britain. His main aim is to rebuild the Third Temple, to welcome the Moshiach, the Antichrist, a man who will bring fake peace and unite the world.
One of the aspects of the Sunnah that is fascinating, and part of the fascination is the fact that the Dajjal is not mentioned clearly in the Quran. Some of the scholars have found implicit verses, but there is no actual mention of the word Dajjal in the Quran, Al-Masih Dajjal. But there are many hadiths in which the Dajjal is mentioned. And the Prophet ﷺ said in a hadith where he talks about the five things that human beings wait for, wealth, al-ghina al-mutghi, the wealth that people transgress, and sudden death, and sickness, and doting old age. The last one he mentioned, the Masih al-Dajjal. The Masih al-Dajjal that will come at the end of time. Sharru fitnatin yuntadhar. This is the evilest of all of the tribulations that is being waited for. The Prophet ﷺ told us in a hadith, I have mentioned, no prophet has come except that he warned his people of the Dajjal. There's no prophet. From all of the prophets, some say 124,000, Allahu A'lam with their number, there's no prophet except that he warned his people of the Masih al-Dajjal. And he says, but I will tell you something about the Masih al-Dajjal that no prophet was given. This information, no prophet was given this information before me. And he said that he is A'war. He is one-eyed, and your Lord is not one-eyed. This is an extraordinary piece of information. He is one-eyed and your Lord is not one-eyed. And this is the definitive statement about the Masih al-Dajjal, because this is the contribution of the Prophet ﷺ in warning his ummah about the nature of al-Masih al-Dajjal. The Christians have a tradition of what they call the Antichrist. And the word anti in Greek means instead of, as well as opposed to. It means instead of or in place of. Christos in classical Greek means the anointed one. The ulama have debated about what it means that the Isa alayhi salam is called al-Masih. Some say it means because he traveled, he was an itinerant, he never stayed in one place at one time. He was a messenger who went to different places constantly. In where he was in Palestine, he moved about and he never took an abode as a permanent resting place. Part of the, and I want to talk about that later, but just to look at this linguistic analysis of the word Masih al-Dajjal. Some of the Muslims called it later Masih al-Dajjal, which is from Masih. The Masih, which is in the Hadith, Masih al-Dajjal, The Messiah can also mean an anointed one, which has the idea that the Greeks took Christos from the Jewish concept of the Messiah, that there would one be coming. The Jews believed that there would be a Messiah that would come and bring them the truth towards the end of time. Isa alayhi salam, when he came, as we know, he was rejected in the Quran, that a group of Bani Israel believed in Isa alayhi salam and a group of Bani Israel disbelieved in Isa. So this is a clear indication from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Isa alayhi salam's message, first of all, was to Bani Israel. Isa alayhi salam is not a universal prophet. He was sent specifically to Bani Israel as a reformer. He was sent with some additions, addendums to the Torah. مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنِ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَةِ I am confirming what I have with the Torah, which is the book that was given to Musa alayhi salam. So he confirmed the book, but he has some changes.